Guys, welcome back to another episode. So in the last few days when I posted about the all about the freelancing, a lot of people asked me that why don't you make a complete episode on the freelancing, how to get clients, how anyone can start with the freelancing. So here is a part one where I'm going to teach you everything about how I started, how you can make everything you want, and how you can start basically freelancing. So this is just a basic part one where I'm going, because if I cannot cover everything in the one video, because that will take around 50 to 60 minutes video or probably more than that. So basically I wanted to teach you everything, all the basic things that you can do to start with your journey. So let's deep dive into the freelancing journey. You have a lot of time right now. You just have to pick it up, right skills, have some direction, and you can start working on your freelancing journey. So we'll first start with a real story, because obviously what is a freelancing, everyone knows about it, but what is a real story, or what is the real story of the freelancing? So I'm going to share my story with you guys, that how I started freelancing, so we'll have a better idea. So this is just a part one. This is just a brief introduction about the freelancing. You will get a better idea as we move to the part two, part three. The more detailed videos you will get, the more understanding you will have about the freelancing. So what is my story? This is a very simple story. It's not a really big one, but this is how I started. This is how I came to know about the freelancing, and that's a very basic love. So I did mechanical engineering. So when I was in last year of mechanical engineering, so I'm a second year, I came across this word called a blog. And I started searching about it, that what is a blog, what to do with the blog. So after that I come to know about what is a blog actually. Then I started writing a couple of articles. So in the last year what happened, while I was posting my blogs, I mean sharing with my friends over the Facebook, one of my friends colleague approached me that would you like to write article for me. So I thought, okay, let's give it a try. So that's become the where I first I wrote article, that I did a ghost writing for that journey. I did an article for that company and they paid me around 150 rupees. So this is where I realized that, okay, we can make money through sitting at anywhere. We can make money we can make money by working online. There is something in this, that online world, that you can make money out of it. And that was my accidental earning. I mean, I never thought about that I can leverage that content writing, or I have no idea that how I can leverage my writing skills, or how I can leverage my creative, or how I can leverage my content writing into next level. So I never went to have or get a job. So, but I never thought about that. That's why I ended up going into the one of the job. So in the 2018, I shifted to the Pune, where I started big shift happened, and I started book blogging also. If you are not following me on Instagram, go and check where I post one of the best books that you should read, and a lot about the book things, and that becomes another profession right now. So I got into the MNC job. I like the most of the people dream for it, like to get into the MNC company, to have a design engineer job. So I had that job in the 2018, about around 3 to 6 months. So while doing that, I realized that this is not something I want to do. This is not something I literally wanted to do for the lifetime. So after that, I went to the depression, and I realized I have to get back to my basics, where the one of the great thing about the, like, I'm going to tell you that the one of the good thing I happened to me, that I got access to the internet in early phase of my life. So I used to find a lot of stuff on the internet. I find easily stuff on the internet. So one thing you have to learn if you wanted to become a freelancing, that how to search perfectly, or how to find data. That's the one of the greatest thing anyone can do, because everything is available on the internet. It just, you either you are lazy, or you don't know the right method to learn thing, or you don't know the right method to find things on the internet. Almost everything, it's like a big ocean. You just have to pick up, you just have to dive in that ocean and find that right moment, or the right cup of the audience, or right cup of the information you want. So I quit my job, then I started fully working on the freelancing. So it took me around 6 to 9 months to get get into the complete freelancing world. So believe me, it takes a lot of time. You cannot just directly jump from the your job and start the freelancing. If you wanted to get start with the freelancing, you have to dedicate it at least minimum 3 months, or maximum depends on 6 to 9 months, depends on how hardly you work. So this is my story, from mechanical engineer to a book blogger to a freelancer to a marketer, and now currently designing games and designing UI UX and working with some of the best companies. If I want to name, I'm currently working with the Flipkart, Amazon, and the Google as a freelancer, and there are some of the other clients also. So this is my story of the freelancing, and after that I'm going to share setting up the right expectations. This is a very important thing. If you see, most of the people, if they wanted to start freelancing, but they don't have right idea what is freelancing, they don't have right expectations that how to start getting with the freelancing, or what are the expectations you have to look for the freelancing. Because see, if you are looking at someone, if you have one of your friend is doing freelancing and he is doing really earning really well, and if you are getting influenced by that person, then you are in the wrong situation. You have to set up your right expectations. First is what you have, what skills you have. Like, I have mechanical engineering skills, but I wanted to shift to the freelancing, so I have to learn new skills. I have to learn something new that I offer as a service to the people. Second thing is why you want to do freelancing. Is it you want freedom? Is it you want flexibility time schedule? Is it you want to make more money? Or is it just like everyone is doing freelancing, that's why you want to do freelancing? So if you are in that thought, I will better suggest you to stick to your job, because it's roller coaster ride. It's not an easy task to do it. Find out how. So this is something I added to the question, but I think I'm going to tell you, find out how. That's the answer of this question you will get by end of this series, the freelancing, the ultimate guide of the freelancing series. So you don't have to worry about the find out how, but you can search on the internet that how you can start with the freelancing, what are the best sources, how you can do all these stuffs you can make by yourself. But obviously this video, or the couple of series, or the couple of upcoming videos, that will help you in a lot of ways. So the next one is mindset is one of the important thing, because in its freelancing, as I told you, that it's one of the hell lot of roller coaster ride. In some months you can make hell lot of money, and in another month you won't make, like, even you can't able to make $10 per month. So this happened with me. That's why I'm telling you, you need a right mindset. What I mean by right mindset, that you have to understand that you have to sacrifice a lot of things if you want a great success or the great results in the future. You have to sacrifice many things. You have to cut your lot of expenses. You have to be in the right mindset. You have to be disciplined. A lot of the exacts that I will couple in the next couple of slides. But keeping your right mindset is very, very important. What happens in job, that when you do a job, the thing is, you have a fixed income, you have a fixed salary, you have a fixed income coming into your bank account monthly. But when you shift to your complete freelancing, it's not like that. If you don't work, if you don't put your work in the hours, you don't get paid. Literally, you don't get paid. So it's equally, you are trading your time, you are trading your performance equals to money. Yes, that's true that you will get high amount at the end of the month, but you have to trade your time, you have to trade your hard work to get that money. It's not like that if you take vacations and you will get paid. So having the right mindset is really, really important if you really want to start with the freelancing. The next part comes is, what is freelancing? So most of the people know what is freelancing. That's why you are watching this video. Probably you are watching this from the Instagram. Probably you are watching this on the YouTube. Whatever you are watching, most of you guys know what is a freelancing. Just, I'm not going to brief more on this slide. This is just self-employed. Either you are a self-employed, you offer services. What are your services? That depends on what skills you have. So I started with the marketing sales, then I started with the book blogging. I do design, I do game design, I offer sales as a service, I offer marketing as a service, I offer content writing, copywriting as a service. So these are the different type of services I sell to the other people, and they pay for me that services. So it's kind of contract work. Either you get paid for the contract. It is a 3 month contract, it is a 6 month contract, or it is a 1 year of contract, depending on what you want to do. Whether you want to do short-term projects, then you can take a short-term contract. But if you want to do long-term projects and if you have a lot of time, then you can go for the long-term contract projects. So this is what the basic of the freelancing, but it depends perfectly on you that what you want to do. So this is the basic of freelancing. The next concept is why freelancing. Obviously, and now you have realized that what is a freelancing, and you have some kind of a mindset that what a freelancer do or what is a contract based freelancing. Now why you want to do freelancing? As I already told you, first thing are you looking for the flexibility? Because I can see this. I used to do work on the 40 hours 30 hours 30 hours weekly. Now I can do that work in a 3 to 4 hours. I mean, that's the difference. And I can use my whatever remaining time to do whatever I want to do in my life. So this is why you want to start. Are you looking for a flexibility? If you are looking for it, then this is the right thing you want to do. But there are a lot of other expectations also column that we will share in the next slide. So are you looking for to be your own boss? Are you tired of your boss? Are you tired of the higher authority? You want to be your own boss, then you are in the right place. You are definitely looking for the freelancing, control over the workload. So these are kind of a pros of the freelancing. I won't say this is a why freelancing. Why freelancing is up to you to figure out that what you are looking for. But this kind of a parallel goes. It's kind of a pros and it's kind of an answer to your why also. So control over the workload. As I already told you, you can take the contract for the limited hours, limited months, or you can take contract for the longer duration, for the 1 year, 2 year, depends on how much you have availability. So you can get the control over workload. So if you say that, okay, in the next month I have a family vacations or family functions, I need more time for myself, then you can take only one month of work. You can work for the 1 month and you can just quit, or you can just stop your work for the next month and you can enjoy with your family. Next one is control over income, which is one of the important part of this freelancing. I mean, obviously the freelancing get paid very highly. Let me tell you one of my example. In the last week I got paid around $300. I will probably show you the screenshot of my PayPal in the next part two, that how that got paid and the story about that. So I got paid around $299 for that around only three hours of work. I mean, that's very, very important. 3 hours of work. Just for the 3 years of work, I got paid around $300. I mean, that's equal to the sum of the monthly salary. I mean, that's the control over income. And if I can do that over the weekly basis, then I can obviously make equal to the sum once annual salary. So that's over the control over the income. That's why if you are looking for the control over income, if you want extra money or if you want something high income, then you can definitely look for the freelancing. But you have to keep in mind that it's a roller coaster life. Sometimes you get payment late, for some months you don't get paid. So you have to channelize everything. You have to get a direction. You have to make it a systematic work for you. That's when the freelancing work for you. So I have been there. I have been like, it's crazy working for 2 years, and now I can definitely guide you on this. So this is the video I wanted to make. Most of the people ask me about to make video on this. So get ready on this. Make sure why you want to do freelancing. Because when I talk about the control over income, in the office days or in the corporate world, you don't get control over income. Like, even if you don't work, you get paid. And sometimes you get a hell lot of project. You have to work overnight, but you will get paid same amount. But here it's not like that. You exactly get paid what you are offering the service. If you offer service for the 3 hours, you get paid for the 3 hours. If you offer service for the 3 months, you get paid for the 3 months. And the end of the day, it's fun. I mean, doing freelancing is always a fun. You can start with the doing as a part-time job. You can start as a, you know, side income. Then when you get idea, okay, now you have some stable income, then you can think about it to going into the deep dive into the freelancing world as a permanent as a freelancer. But if you really wanted to get just a basic idea about it, then I will highly suggest you to have a high stress start as a side income or start as a hustle, side hustle. Then if you get basic idea, then you can deep dive into it, because it's not like that everyone is made for this mindset. Because I quit my job and I directly started working on the freelancing because I was damn sure about it. I have I had that right kind of my mindset. I have discipline. I have worked on different projects, and I had that network. I have that network where I can know what people will get me, what projects, how to get projects, and how to work in this field. So after that, I immediately able to shift. But if you are not in this zone, you have no idea, then I will better suggest you to go with the side by side, go with the parallel. But keeping in mind that if you are looking at the freelancing is a long term journey, then you should definitely think about it. So next part comes is why not freelancing. We already talk about the why you should do the freelancing. Then it is equally important that why not freelancing, because if you don't clear with your why, then you are going to I don't want to pick up the wrong words, you are going to screw up your life in the future if you don't have setting up your right expectations. So why not freelancing? If you cannot control your emotions, then freelancing is not for you. See, emotions plays a very important role in your human life, whether you are a corporate job, whether you are doing freelancing. You have to keep emotions aside, you have to keep your professional job aside, you have to keep your business aside. So if you want to start with the freelancing, you have to have 100% control over the emotion. You cannot just let me do it in some other day, I will just go out today, I won't do it today. It's not like that. You have to control, you have to do very high control over the emotion. The second thing, why not freelancing? If you are looking for the perk, because in this freelancing, you don't get perks. Like if you go for the corporate jobs, you get perks like getting Sodexo card, health insurance, and a lot of things you get for the free. But in freelancing, you don't get any of this. You have to define what you want. You have to discover what perks you want. And it's like awarding yourself. But obviously the freelancing get more options in that option in freelancing, but as compared to the corporate life, here you don't get any perk. If you are not good at management, then freelancing is not for you. See, at the starting, you will get only one or two clients. But when you are looking for the higher income, then when you shift to getting 3 to 5 clients monthly, then you need a management system. You have to be very good at management, because you cannot just stumble on the different clients and just worry about it. Because at the end of the day, if you lose client, then you will get depressed, you won't make money, you won't able to survive. So all these things have to manage by you. The first thing manage you have to is to manage your finances. The second thing manage your timetable. The third thing, you have to manage your emotions. The fourth thing, you have to manage your clients. All these things you have to keep in mind. While if you're not good at management, then freelancing is not for you. Secure income. If you are looking for the secure income, then freelancing is not for you. Okay, I'm not kidding, I'm serious about it. If you are looking for secure income, in that say, in the corporate life, you get monthly paycheck. But if you are looking for a monthly paycheck in the freelancing, then it's not for you. Then never you should definitely go for the corporate job. This is not for you. If you cannot handle high ups and high downs, what I mean by that is, in the some months you will get paid for around $1,000, $2,000, or more than $5,000. But in some months you don't even get paid for $100. I mean, that's happened with me. That's the reality. That's the real time example. I have been there. I can tell you that you get a hell lot of ups and downs. You have to manage a lot of things in this. But fear not. I mean, I'm here. I'm gonna teach you all these things. How to get out of this situation, how to manage your perks, how to be a good at manager, how to make a secure income, how to manage all your expenses, how to manage clients. I'm gonna tell you everything in this journey. So just stay tuned for it. If you are really dedicated, then just my request is just stick to the video, just dedicate it completely, and you will get most of this. The next thing is characteristics of the freelancing. Okay. So as we talk about if you wanted to become a really, really passionate about the freelancing, or now at this point, by this slide, you have to figure out whether you are want to become a full-time freelancer or not, whether you are serious about it or you are just influenced by someone, that's why someone is doing it, that's why I want to do it, or you are really passionate about your future or really something doing in the future, or you see there is no life in the corporate, then you can think about it. So what are the characteristics of the freelancer? Freelancer has to be disciplined. So discipline is one of the important thing when you start with the freelancing, because without discipline you cannot learn skill, without discipline you cannot manage your clients, and you cannot do all the management. So discipline is one of the important thing. If you don't have, then please don't come into the freelancing. The second thing is resilience. This is also one of the important part if you are starting with the freelance. The third thing is organization. It's one of the important part of the freelancing. Believe me, if you are not good at organizing things, like not literally each and everything you have to organize, whether it's a contract, whether it's a small details, whether it's your future contract or whether it's your different clients, you have to understand a lot of things and you have to manage it very, very properly. That's why you need a organization skill. Next one is you have to keep on the updated and cumulative. So by means, what I mean by updated, you have to keep learning new things, because at the same, take out the example of the Nokia. Yeah, Nokia is one of the best company in the past time, but they don't update themselves over the Android. That's why they lose their market. So it's important to update yourself with the upcoming skills, with the new things. If you want to compete with the freelancing journey. See, in the freelancing, your competition is behind the screen. You cannot see anyone in this freelancing journey. So if you want to be ready with the freelancer, then you have to be very updated in this journey. So these are the characteristics. So it's not like that, because see, I have, like, this is the example I give to the everyone, that consider there is a ABC person, and A person knows only only management, B person knows management and design, and C person knows management, design, plus he has some extra skills, how to close the calls, how to manage a team, and how to do the sales properly. So obviously the hiring of the C greater than A and B, because if you are an entrepreneur or if you are a business person, you will rather choose who can do all your work at one go than going for the different people. So that's why you have to understand all these characteristics of the freelancing. And if you have to now retrospect yourself, I mean, do the analysis of your with how many skills do you have? Are you really good at it? Are you the person who just uses social media all the time and time? Are you a disciplined person? Do you have organization skills? If you don't have, start building these skills. So if you don't have, and if you want to just enjoy your life, then freelancing is not for you. If you are really serious about it, then you have to develop these skills. It's not really hard to develop these skills. So if I want to learn something new, it takes me around only 30 to 60 hours to learn something new, whether it's designing. So currently I started learning designing, UI, UX designing. Then I started with the game designing, a lot of web designing also. I started with the coding also. I started with all these things. So it took me around 30 to 60 hours to learn these skills. I mean, I have developed that skills, that how to learn the skills. There is also one important point I'm going to share, that how to be creative, how to learn these skills in the future videos. future parts of this video. So that's all for the characteristics. So now your job is to understand everything. Why freelancing? Why not is freelancing? Where you fit right now, whether you are ready for it, whether you are not ready for it. Be honest with you, because see, if you don't keep honesty with you, there is no chance of going future in this freelancing journey. If you don't keep honesty with you, because you are going to screw up your life in the future. So be honest with you. So this is all end of the part one. What you have to do first, understand what you have, how many skills you have, what you can offer as a service, what I mean by what you have is how much you are pro at that skill. It's not like this, I just know content writing and I can just start working on it. No, you are not going to succeed in that. And I just know web designing, I can start with the web design. How much you are pro at it, how much portfolio you have, how much project you have done, how much dummy project you have done, how much like free work you have done. You have to understand that. The second thing you have to understand, what is your emotional value? How much you give importance to your emotions, whether like, okay, like you are just lying on the bed, okay, and now you think just keep surfing on the social media, or you just have discipline to get out of and work on something. Third thing is security. In freelancing, at the starting couple of years, you don't get any security. So if you are looking for the security, then freelancing is not for you. Are you okay with risk? I mean, a really, really important factor. Are you okay with taking risk for another 1 or 2 years? I mean, see, understand this. If you take risk today, and if you're able, like most of the people who took risk in my like in my analysis, they become successful. I mean, I can see this graph from the last, like I have did this analysis for the couple of years, and I know most of the people who take risk, took risk, they become successful. So are you okay with the risk? Are you okay with the hustle for another 1 or 2 years and get a good life after that? Are you okay with that? Or you won't just enjoy your life by day to day, and you just have okay with your monthly check pick, where you are just enjoying limited resources and you just see other people having fun. So if you're okay with risk, then freelancing is for you. I mean, you have to do all this analysis for yourself, what skills you have. So it is one of the next video, we're going to talk about a lot about the skills and different education system, that what is it and how you can start with it. So what skills you have, understand whether you are a mechanical engineer, whether you are a commerce guy, whether you are an art student, understand what skills you have. If you don't have any skills, then what skills you are interested in currently, just understand what skills you have. In the next video, we are going to talk about the high paying skills. Already made a video on the 8 high paying skills, which you can have the link in the description. Go check that video if not. And the next one I am talk about is what skills you have. Just understand what skills you have, just retrospect yourself that what skills you have. Next thing is connect me to our Instagram. If you have any questions about the freelancing, whether it's about the book reading, what books I recommend for the freelancing, how to get into the freelancing journey, or how you can start with the freelancing. So this is, if you have any questions, go on the Instagram, hit the follow button and put up your message. Or if you want me to release part 2 ASAP, because I have a lot of clients to work with, I have to handle my bookstagram, I have to handle my marketing clients, I have to handle social media, all these things I have to do. So it's a quite a busy schedule. Still I am getting time to make this type of the video, so people can get start with the education system, they can start working on themselves and they have a better life. So if you want me to release part 2 ASAP, then just DM me with the part 2 and I will try to make it part 2 ASAP. And it's going to be a very long series, so it's probably we're going to talk about the education system, we are going to talk about the skills, we are going to talk about the portfolio, how to build portfolio, how to get clients and all those things. But before that, understanding yourself is very, very important. If you are ready with the understanding, if you have watched this video till the end, go on the Instagram, put part 2 or I have watched your video. Another thing I want from you guys is share this video with a lot of people. See, now I have understood what is a freelancing. I have at a really good position where I can share all this knowledge with you. Now I want you to guys do the same with your life. When you get some knowledge, share with the world. Because see, we are living here. Ultimately, if you help others to grow, you become really, you get some authority that, okay, you are doing something great in your life and you can share with your world. So my aim is to end goal is share whatever I have for the free for the everyone. And I want you to guys today, if you are a selfish person, you want to get good results in the long run. I can become a selfish today and I can just delete all this video. I can just earn a lot of money and just say, show you the final results. But that's not my goal. My goal is to teach. My goal is to educate. My goal is to learn everything. I mean, learn maximum things and share with the world. And I want you to guys do this thing. It's not my thing that if you are, I know copyright, it's really hard to do things in the world. But if you are a selfish person, then you are not going to survive in the long run. So get rid of that ego person. I mean, I have seen these people going like they don't share thing with the other people. They hesitate to share with the other. I have seen this in the bookstagram also. I have seen this in the life a lot of times. So, but I am not that kind of guy where I talk about selfishness. But I'm literally out of that zone where I just focus on the learning, where I just focus on educating people. So if you want to educate others, start with today. Just share this video, they will get better idea. Even they get better, they can handle their family really well, they can survive really well. So that's all for this today's video. Hope you have a better idea what is a freelancing, and just stay tuned for my video. Just the kind request is subscribe to this channel and share with all the friends who want to start getting with the freelancing. So that's all for today. See you on the Instagram. See you on the next video. Bye bye.